Hey, good afternoon, guys. John Kerry, 1963 Jag. It's time to take a break and have a celebration. So here we go. One-handed beer opening. Steady, slow. Can I do it?
I did it.
Hey, Neil, check it out. Your name fell out of that thing. I don't know how it did, but c'est la vie. I still think of you every time I use it. It's 3:15, and we're going to go downtown to see the Music in the Park today, the summertime music in Los Gatos. It's always nice. It's 92, 93 in here, and it's been a little warm. Been working on the car, though. I got a lot done. Start with the most obvious and things that you can see from the outside. I put the rain gutter chrome trim on. So this piece that goes across from here and runs up and down the front A-pillar. And then looking inside the car, I put these crash rails on that are the ones that go around the top edge of the window. I had put the bottom one on over there the other day, and I couldn't put the top ones on until I had the header rail back in, and I couldn't put the header rail back in until the windshield was installed. So I've got the trim for the visors and the rearview mirrors in now, and that's the original mirror, so it's got a little blackness down at the very bottom there, and I'm not kind of don't care, but right in that corner you can kind of see it. But I think it's kind of quaint, you know, having the original 50-year-old mirror. So crash rails, in Jaguar terms, called cant rails. I tightened up the grab handle now and put the bracket on because the cant rail had to go in first. A lot of, you know, got to do this before you can do that kind of thing. So getting all that stuff in was basically took me all day. So there you have it. I had to take these chrome uprights off in order to put that that rain gutter in, because it didn't quite fit with the chrome in the way. So that's about it. I put the knobs on the choke handle and the heater handles today, but that was just, you know, a little something to kill a few minutes here as I was winding down and cleaning up. So as I sit here looking at the car and thinking about what am I going to do next, I'm probably going to put these rear windows together. I got to get them down from the loft, but you know, they're a chrome U-channel frame, and I've got some glass setting tape that you snap in there, and or you press over the glass. I think you lay it over the glass and then press the glass into the frame. And people that have done that and that have written up about it have said that it's a little challenging. It takes quite a bit of pressure to get those things to go in there, but WD-40 or something, some soap or something, probably will help. My pile of parts is getting small. Check this out. You know, the console. I tried to fit the console the other day, and I had a little trouble with it. So I went on the internet and asked some advice, and a couple of guys tell me that you might have to loosen the mounting screws for the emergency brake in order to get it to go in. A few people have had that problem. Others say, no, you don't have to. It should work. But for whatever reason, mine doesn't want to go in. The distance between the gear shift lever, when it's pressed all the way up here, and the emergency brake when it's pulled all the way up, that distance there is still a little too narrow. My emergency brake hits right about here. It doesn't want to go through the gap, so, you know, it's not the end of the world. I'll just loosen the bracket and push it in. So I'll probably get to that. I was thinking I might get to that today, but I really didn't have enough time. This has taken me since about, I got out here about 9 o'clock, and we're going downtown about 4:30, so in about an hour, and I'm all sweaty, and my knees hurt from crawling around on the knee on my knees over here working on this side of the car. This car is low. You know, to get at things, I have to kind of, you know, kneel on my... That's why I have all this cardboard down here. It's my kneeling pads. Much easier to kneel on that than it is on concrete. I also am going to do my rear window, but I'm kind of waiting to get some help, so I need a helper for that, and I don't know. Maybe I'll give it a try later tonight. My daughter's boyfriend is coming over, and he's a pretty handy guy, so I might give it a try a little bit later this afternoon, evening, after dinner, maybe, something like that. So I hope everybody's having a good day. I put up the big video the other day on the windshield installation, and I recorded a little thank you to Cutworm, and I think it got lost or cut, so I'm just going to say one more time, Cutworm, I did get your stickers and your letter. Thank you very much. I actually got two shipments of stickers. I got Betty Page on a rocket. I got the Crosley magnetic, the Cutworm magnetic, and then I got this other little peel-off Crosley sticker, which I put over here. So thanks for that. It's really good. And I've been watching as many videos as I possibly can, guys, trying to catch up. Sorry, some of your stickers are covered by my to-do list. but we're getting there, little by little. And feeling very enthusiastic that I'll be able to drive this car before too much longer. I'm really convinced that we're really not far from it at all. So I can't wait. That's going to be one fun video to record while I take this thing out for its first little run. I'll probably just drive it around up here on the top of the hill, you know, in my parking area to just kind of get a feel for it a little bit. But all the big stuff is done. Just piddling away at the little stuff now. So. Everybody have a great weekend, week at work, and happy 4th of July coming up. So we got a long weekend coming up. So I'll be out here doing it, maybe even getting it done by that weekend. Wouldn't that be great? Okay, guys. Listen, I'll talk to you soon. Thanks. And remember, it's Jaguar parking only. Okay? So if you have other kinds of cars, just beware, they might be crushed. Talk to you later.